literally be inspired by it, not copy it. I actually don't like copying a lot of stuff because some of it doesn't work. They look great on film, and then you try to make it in real life, and you're like, wow, that doesn't work. No wonder they only shot them from this angle. And of course, with a lot of the replica swords and everything from Lord of the Rings, beautiful designs. But because they're made out of stainless steel, they're heavy and unbalanced. Real swords should balance right in front of the guard. And basically, what I do is I take either 1095 high carbon spring steel, or in this case, this is 6061T aircraft aluminum. And I actually get the bars and grind the blade out because I don't have access to a forge, and probably I'll get sued or fined or something if I have something that generates that much heat. But with the steel, I do my own heat treating because I do get, it's a spring steel, so it's the type of steel that you can actually bend, you know, about 12 to 15 inches out of line, and they'll come back to normal if you heat treat it properly. And that's the heating, quenching, tempering, and all that, and it's a nice, flexible, functional sword, because functional swords really need to be flexible to work. But it usually takes about, depending on the material and the sword, it usually takes about 3 to 6 days. But this one took about 4 to make this one. And basically, since these are based on Eastern designs, kind of like Japanese swords are very similar in profile to it, I basically took that because I've done a lot of martial arts and actually taught how to use Japanese swords and everything, and kind of put an elven spin on it. It's a hand and a half sword, so you can use 2 hands on it if you need to. This one's about 36 inches, which is too long for me to draw off my hip, which is why it's got a little slit in the scabbard here. Mm-hmm. Besides not having an unsightly hump for this piece there, I can actually draw it to about here and just swing it right out. So that might be a little longer off my hip. And this is a lot like Katafai that has that little notch there, partially because I can use this area to block other swords without damaging the blade, but also if I'm really close to somebody, I can actually grasp the sword here and have a much shorter weapon. So little design thoughts into it because I've done SAA combat also. So yeah, that's about all I think.
When you grind it out though, what do you mean you grind it out?
Oh, well, it starts with a straight bar, and then I draw a pattern on it, and then I have a grinding jig that I made that I can set to various angles.
And so you just sort of sit
yeah,
there.
Just kind of
what do you do with the shading? Do you do this in your house or your